Oh, I really need to get this work done.
You need to get done.
Oh, thank you. I've never seen anything like that.
Oh, yes, sir. Well, I had to.
Go home.
I'll just get this work done, and then I'll go home for lunch, if that's okay with you, sir.
Please.
How long?
I don't know. Good morning. Thank you, sir.
We'll have all this finished by 3 o'clock. You're probably going to have to skip lunch. And
I can't let her do this.
Okay. Paycheck for you.
Jake, come back to Mama right now! Just isn't any easy way to say this, John. I need your help.
What kind of help?
Money help? Look, I know you've got...
Why are you asking me for money?
John, please. John, where are you going?
I have my own money.
I knocked on your door this morning to check on the young lady you got staying with you. Nobody answered. Congratulations.
I just need everything back to how it was before.
Have you even called anybody?
Yes, sir.
Listen here.
No, sir.
Okay?
Yes, sir. Did I do something wrong?
Don't speak to my wife that way.
Well, the train's gonna be gone on Friday because I spoke to Mr. Clapp. He said...
How about this?
That's really something, isn't it, Johnny?
Connor, this is our guy. John Scopa, meet Connor Black.
It's a pleasure to meet you.
Now, Mark Huggins is coming to take that train away on Friday, and that's it.
Yeah, your wife.
You're in my house.
What we'd like to do is hold a political rally in your backyard, using the train as a backdrop.
Well, she's not the boss of me.
Oh, we know you're the man of the house, John.
Oh, you don't know what you're doing. Everything just needs to get back to how it was before. Mr. Clapp promised the train would be gone on Friday, and that's what needs to happen.
John.
Oh, no, well, it's my house. I don't know what she told you. I don't know what she told you, but she is not the boss of me. I make the decisions, not Emma. I'm the man of the house.
Oh, John. Hello.
What's this?
I wanted to say thank you to you and Emma for, well, everything you're doing. Marcy, just say hi to Emmy for me. You gotta go home.
You don't understand. I can't go back home. I can't go back home. Where do you want to go? Where do you want to go? I'll take you wherever you want to go. I'll take you.
Okay. Madison.
I'll take you there. I'll give you the money and I'll take you to Madison. I'll give you all the money, all of it. I've got $1,409.16. She's not my wife. Mr. French, what would you do without me?
find someone more reliable.
John? John, are you okay?
No. I can't go home.
No, I swear I didn't.
She held my head underwater.
She's not taking care of me anymore. Yeah, she would have liked Emma. On the day I'm long dying.
Okay, buddy, look. We gotta get you home, okay? John? Let's get you home.
I can't go.
Oh, hello, John. It's always nice to see a friendly face.
Hello, Mrs. Sternberg.
Louise. Call me Louise.
Hello, Mrs. Sternberg.
Must get lonely in that house.
Well, excuse me.
John, I don't want to hear another word out of you.
No one understands, sir.
I don't understand how your wife can see how big this is, and you don't. You need to sit here and think about this.
Oh, what is she doing?
I want to donate these.
Come on in. Just toss them on the chair. John?
When did she do this?
Do what?
No.
John. John, what's wrong?
I can't let her do this. Maggie, you need to stay away from Emma. I'll give you the money so you can leave.
Are you serious?
No. No, I said no, Rally!
But Emma told me yesterday it was okay.
Emma? Now get out! Get out! All of you!
John, no, John, no. You've got to control yourself.
Shut up!
Okay, fellas, let's take a break.
Where were you yesterday? You weren't at work all day. I called your house several times. Several times, John. Mm-hmm. Your wife could pick up the phone. Mm-hmm.
Peacock State Bank.
You're going to have to skip lunch today.
Okay. Sure. Yeah. Just one second.